emerging right on my finger.
It's on the rod. It's on the rod.
Look, it's emerging right on my finger. It's coming out of its shuck. See how he's wiggling his way out? Look at that. The fly I'm going to be tying for you today is an adaptation to Frank Sawyer's very famous pheasant tail nymph pattern. Frank Sawyer was a river keeper over in England in the early 1900s, and he developed this pattern to replicate the mayfly nymph. It has since been used around the world. It's probably one of the most effective patterns, if not the most effective nymph pattern there is. There are over 200 species of mayflies worldwide, ranging in size. This one I'm focusing on is for the Hendrickson hatch. I'm using a tan thread to match the body of the Hendrickson, and I'm also using a gray CDC to match the wings. The adaptations that I'm putting into this are some crystal flash on the underbody of the nymph, and the CDC puff at the top to hold it into the film. The thinking is the life cycle of the mayfly, usually they're, depending upon what kind, they're on the bottom of the river for about a year. At some point they begin to change. They develop a translucent gas that makes them float to the surface. Once they reach the surface, they have to break the surface film where they shed their exoskeleton, fly off, molt again, are then mature adults. They mate in the air, return to the water, lay their eggs, and the whole cycle continues again. Now, what I'm keying on is the point at which the nymph has floated to the surface, and in many cases, they don't have the energy to break through the film, or they stay on the top before they get out of their exoskeleton and fly off. One of the characteristics of the Hendrickson hatch is they tend to stay on the water longer than some of the other mayflies. So anyway, I'm concentrating on the nymphal stage stuck in the film, and a very vulnerable stage at that. Never give up on your cast when you've reached the end of your drift. A lot of times is the action by just lifting the tip of your rod simulates an emerging mayfly. So anyway, those are the adjustments I've made. I'm not too concerned about the size of the head on this fly. In fact, I've made it a little bigger than normal, only because it replicates again the exiting mayfly coming out of the shuck. So I hope you enjoy this pattern. I'm looking forward to the Hendrickson hatch. Obviously, I'm restocking my box right now, and that's the first one of the season that I'm focusing on. So thanks for watching, and tight lines to you. Yeah.
Just wanna let a little me